Now let us discuss about the chapter blood relations. Okay, blood relation between two individuals is defined as the relation between them by the virtue of their birth rather than by marriage. Okay, you can be related either by marriage or by birth. By the virtue of being born in that family, you are related, or you get married, so you get married to your spouse and their family. Okay, different type of questions that can be covered in this chapter would be blood relations based on conversation, blood relation based on puzzles, and symbolically coded blood relation. We'll look at it, each of them in detail. But before that, let us understand what are relationships. Okay, it starts from you. The blood relations, basically you become, the person becomes the base from which we go above three generations and we go below three generations. Generally, more than three generations will not be asked. Okay. In competitive exams, they don't cross more than three generations. Okay, when you say above, you start from yourself. Above three generations would be your father, grandfather, and great grandfather. Okay, from you, below three generations would be, after you, it would be your son, grandson, great grandson. Okay, now three generations above. Okay, if it's a male person, it could be great grandfather, like maternal grandfather, or great grandfather-in-law. Okay, when you're talking about three generations above you, okay, it could be your great grandfather, it could be your maternal grandfather, or it could be your great grandfather-in-law. Okay, great grandfather, as you know, your father's father's father, three generations above. Maternal grandfather, maternal great grandfather means, okay, your mother's father's father. Okay, paternal is your father's side. Maternal is your mother's side. Okay, when you say paternal, it goes your great grand, your father's father's father, whereas when you say maternal, your mother's father's father. Okay, great grandfather-in-law, similarly your great grandfather-in-law would be your wife's great grandfather. Okay, if three generations above we are considering a female relationship, that means we are considering a lady or a female, then it could be a great grandmother or your maternal great grandmother. That means your mother's, on from your mother's side, we are counting the grandmother, great grandmother, or your great grandmother-in-law. That means your wife's great grandmother. Okay. If you are considering two generations above, okay, if it's a male person, it could be a grandfather, it could be your grandfather, means your father's father, or it could be your maternal grandfather, that means your mother's father, or your grandfather-in-law, that means your wife's grandfather. Okay, that is two generations if you are considering male. If you are considering a female, two generations above, it could be your grandmother, that means your father's mother, it could be your maternal grandmother, that means your mother's mother, and or it could be your grandmother-in-law, that is your wife's grandmother. This is two generations above. If you are talking about one generation above, it could be your father, it could be your uncle. Okay, uncle means your father's elder brother or younger brother, either one. Or it could be your maternal uncle. Okay, that means your mother's brother or father-in-law. This is one generation above. Father-in-law means your wife's father. Okay, it could be even your father-in-law's cousin also you can take. Okay, it could be your mother-in-law's cousin also you can take. They come one generation above. Okay, if you are talking one generation above as a female relationship, then it could be your mother, your aunt. Aunt again could be your mother's sister, elder sister or younger sister, or it could be even your father's younger sister or elder sister, or maternal aunt. Maternal aunt is your mother's sister and mother-in-law. Okay, that is your wife's mother. It could be your mother-in-law's sister also, younger or elder sister. That also comes under a female relationship one generation above. Okay, then we'll come into current generation. Current generation could be the person's husband, the lady's husband, or a brother, or a cousin, or a brother-in-law, etc. Or it could be your wife's brother also. That could also be a male relationship in the current generation. If you are talking about current generation and a female relationship, it could be your wife. If it's a man, it could be his wife, his sister, cousin, sister-in-law. Okay, or his wife's brother also could be his wife's sister also could be a female relationship in the current generation. Okay, then let's come to one generation below. One generation below could be a son or a nephew or a son-in-law. Okay, nephew could be your sister's son or brother's son, or your wife's sister's son or wife's brother's son. That both of them qualify for a nephew or a one generation below relationship. Okay, if you are talking about a female relationship one generation below, then it could be your daughter, niece, daughter-in-law. Okay, again, niece could be your person's brother's daughter or sister's daughter, or the person's wife's brother's daughter or person's wife's sister's daughter. They come under one generation below female relationship. Let's look at two generations below male relationship. It could be grandson or grandson-in-law. Okay, that means your granddaughter's husband. Okay, grandson also, it could be your son's son, or your nephew's son also could be a grandson, or your niece's son could be in the relationship of a grandson category only. This is two generations below. If you are talking about two generations below female relationship, it could be your granddaughter or granddaughter-in-law. That means your grandson's wife, that she will become your granddaughter-in-law. Okay, when you're talking about granddaughter, that means your son's daughter or your daughter's daughter, that is two generations below. Or it could be your nephew's son, nephew's daughter, or niece's daughter also. Even that qualifies as a grandson two generation below relationship. Okay, now let us look at three generations below. Three generations below could be great grandson. Okay, great grandson-in-law, that means your great granddaughter's husband. Similarly, a female relationship could be great granddaughter or great granddaughter-in-law, that means your great grandson's wife. That also qualifies as a female relationship three generations down the line. Now let us look at some techniques to solve this problem. Okay, always draw the family hierarchy based on the information given. The information given in the question, okay, draw a family hierarchy chart. That helps simplify the question to a great extent and get an information, complete understanding about the question and the relationships. Okay, correlate the relation given in the question with your personal relationships. It's always advisable that the scenario given in the question, you relate it to yourself. Okay, like for example, if they say your father's brother, that means you relate it to your father's father, that is your grandfather's brother, who also turns out to be your cousin grandfather or grandfather. Always correlate it to your family personal relationship. Okay, one more important thing is never assume gender based on the name. Okay, for example, H is given or F is given or any particular name is given. Never conclude the gender. Okay, that is a trick which many of the examiners play. Okay, first you conclude, analyze the relationship, and then you assume, or then you conclude the gender. Okay, right at the beginning, do not conclude the gender. Okay, the first type of questions would be blood relation based on conversation. Okay, while you converse with each other, okay, like for example, my sister's brother's son. Okay, general day-to-day conversations when you do, in that kind of scenario, what are the blood relations we can have? In this kind of questions, we'll be using lot of symbols. As you can see on the screen, okay, on the left side, you have the symbol, okay, then the meaning and the symbol, what it implies. The plus means generally male. Generally, what they use, these are basic conventional symbols. They can again differ from question to question and competitive exam to competitive exams. But whatever is the scenario, they will specify it at the beginning of the question that this symbol means that. Okay, we are giving a general idea of the symbols. Plus means male, minus means female. Okay, when plus is parallelly connected, okay, laterally with a minus, then it becomes a husband-wife relationship. Okay, again, plus and plus, that would be a brother-brother relationship. Minus and minus would be a female and female. So that could be a sister-sister relationship. Plus and minus, okay, it could also mean husband and wife, but plus and minus could also be at the same level, at the same generation, it could be a brother sister relationship. Okay, when you have a plus and downward it is going a plus, then it's a father son relationship. If it's a plus and downward it's going minus, then it's a father daughter relationship. It could be father daughter, or it could also be a father a niece relationship. That also could be a possibility. If you have a minus and plus, it could mean a mother-son relationship, and a minus-minus could be a mother-daughter relationship. Okay, these are broadly the symbols which they use. Again, it depends on exam to exam and question to question. Certain symbols are defined, okay, at that particular question, and we need to follow that. Okay, let's look at some examples. Okay, the question, as you can see on the screen, goes as follows. Amit said to Mohan that a boy in the red shirt is younger of the two brothers of the daughter of my father's wife. Okay, how is the boy in the red shirt related to Amit? Option A, father. Option B, uncle. Option C, brother. And option D, nephew. I'll repeat the question once again. Amit said to Mohan, okay, that boy in red shirt is younger of the two brothers of the daughter of my father's wife. Okay, how is the boy in the red shirt related to Amit? Quite a complicated scenario, but if we draw the family hierarchy and proceed step by step categorically, we'll be able to decipher it very easily. Let us reiterate the statement. Okay, Rahul said to Mahesh that the boy in the red shirt is younger of the two brothers of the daughter of my father's wife. Okay, now how is the boy in the red shirt related to Rahul? There's a person called Rahul. He told to Mahesh that there's a boy in the red shirt. Okay, he is younger of the two brothers of the daughter of my father's wife's, of my father's wife. Okay, obviously Mahesh's father's wife is his mother or stepmother. Okay, either of the situations, but generally we can take it as the mother. Okay, so Rahul's father's wife is his mother. Now, the boy in the red shirt is younger of the two brothers of the daughter of my father's wife. Okay, father's wife's daughter would be Rahul's sister. Okay, as you can see on the screen, there's a diagram. Okay, first, let's go laterally upwards. First, let's draw the family hierarchy curve. Okay, let's start with Rahul, the base point. Okay, Rahul's father. Okay, let's vertically go upward and draw Rahul's father. Now, he said Rahul's father's wife. Rahul's father's wife would be Rahul's mother or stepmother, whichever is the case. Let's horizontally draw a relationship line to Rahul's mother, okay, or Rahul's father's wife. Let's draw a circle. Okay, now he's saying younger of the two brothers of the daughter of father's wife. Daughter of father's wife. Okay, that means Rahul's mother's daughter. So again, come laterally, vertically downwards. Okay, and draw daughter of Rahul's mother. Daughter of Rahul's mother would obviously be Rahul's sister. Now, the person in the red shirt is younger of the two brothers of Rahul's father's wife's daughter. So, that means the daughter's brother is person in the red shirt. So, let's draw horizontally the relationship at the same parallel level, that is the person in the red shirt. Okay, if you draw it. Okay, now he's saying that he is one among the two brothers. From the diagram, you can clearly see that Rahul's mother's daughter, that means Rahul's sister, has two brothers. One is Rahul himself and other one is in the boy in the red shirt. Okay, so the boy in the red shirt is brother of Rahul. Okay, mother's daughter's brother means his sister's brother. Sister's brother means he is my brother. Okay, my brother or my stepbrother. But either ways, the relationship is that of a brother. Okay, so he is Rahul's brother. So option would be option D. You can freeze on that.